Hello all, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install Microsoft Visual Studio on a Windows operating system. So let's begin. Now to install Microsoft Visual Studio, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in that dashboard you need to just simply search with Microsoft Visual Studio download and hit enter, and you will get this visualstudio.microsoft.com as your first search result. So here you need to just simply click on download Visual Studio tools, and this is going to redirect to the official site of Microsoft Visual Studio. And here you can see we have Microsoft Visual Studio 2022 is available to download. So if you scroll down, you can see that it is also available for Mac, and Visual Studio Code is completely different. It's a text editor, whereas this is the IDE. Okay. So here, depending upon what operating system you are using, for Windows you need to proceed with these links, and for Mac you need to proceed with this link. So here, if you see, we have Community, Professional and Enterprise. So here the Community one is the free, and Professional and Enterprise are the paid one. So if you are a student, or if you are interested to learn just .NET, then you can use the Community one, or if you are into building any enterprise application, then you need to proceed with these links, right? So just simply click on this free download, and it's going to start downloading our Visual Studio setup. So here is the installer. So just simply click on the installer. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Just simply click on yes. Let's minimize our download directory, and here you need to just simply click on continue. So let's wait for a couple of minutes to finish it downloading the required files. Once all the file gets downloaded, you are going to see this page. So here you can see that we have several options, right? So from here, let's check this ASP.NET, because we mainly use Visual Studio for .NET programming, right? And Azure development also you can choose if you want to push your code to Azure and all. So for that you can select this. For Python also you can select. For Node.js also if you can select. So if you are using all these, then you need to select this. I'm not going to use any of these. I'm only going to use it for .NET. So I'm going to select only .NET, and then I'm just simply going to scroll down, and here you can see that for desktop and mobile we have several options. So from here, I'd like to choose this .NET desktop development, because with .NET we mainly develop for desktop applications. You can also use Visual Studio for .NET multi-platform app UI development. So if you want, you can select that. For desktop development with C++, which is I'm going to select, because in my coming videos I'm going to show you about C++ on Visual Studio. So I'm going to check that. And if you are into mobile development, you can select all this. And I'm also going to select this universal Windows platform development, right? So then I'm going to scroll down. If you are into gaming, you can select all this, or and this is the most important thing, data storage and processing. So this will help to connect with our backend database. And if you are into developing any Visual Studio extension, then you can select all this. If you are into data science, you can select this, and subsequently depending upon your users, you can select all this, right? So just simply select this much, and you can see here the total space required is 24.4 GB, so that's quite big. So you need to have this much amount of free space on your C drive, remember that. So all these things, whatever you are installing, going to take about 25 GB, right? So that's the point. So all other things are rightly fine. Just simply click on install, and what it will do is it will going to start installing. So for that it's going to download. So real download process is just began. Okay, so you need to have active internet connection right throughout this installation. So you can see nearly 6 GB of data they're going to download. So after downloading that, they're going to install, and once everything gets installed, around 25 GB of space is going to take up on our C drive. So that's the thing. So this entire process will take some time, about 15 to 20 minutes I would say. It depends upon your internet speed and your system performance as well. Right, so give some time. You can grab some coffee and come back. So I'll be doing the same. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Visual Studio installer is rightly installed. So you can say Visual Studio Community 2022 is rightly installed. So all installations are up to date. So you can see we have modify, launch, and more button. So from here you need to click on launch. And it's going to start launching our Microsoft Visual Studio 2022. So you can minimize this launcher and wait for a couple of minutes to launch our Microsoft Visual Studio. And you can see that our Microsoft Visual Studio is likely launched. So here it is asking to create a new account. So you can always create a new account by just simply clicking on create a new account. And it's going to redirect to the browser. So here under create account, you need to create a new Microsoft account. So you need to use your phone number or anything. You can also create a new email ID from clicking this button, right? So you can create a new account from Microsoft, or else for now you can just simply skip this. And here you can choose the theme you'd like to use. So we have a dark theme, blue, then blue extra contrast, and then light. So I'm going to choose dark, and I'm going to choose proceed with the start Visual Studio. So in here, in under get started, you can see we have four options. So what I'm going to show you now is how we can easily create a new project. Okay, so that's what this fourth option is. So just simply click on that, and here is our create a new project window. So in here you can see we have this language drop down. So from here you can choose on which language you want to code. So we have C sharp, C++, F sharp, JavaScript, Python, query language, TypeScript, Visual Basic, and XML. Right. Similarly, if you see the platform, you can start coding for all these different platforms like Android, Azure, Linux, Mac OS, Windows, Xbox, and whatnot. Right. So you have several platforms as well, and the type of project also you can see. Like, let's say you want to create a console app, which is I'm going to show you right now. So you can see about that. So from here I'm going to choose the console app. So I'm going to choose the console, and here you can see our console app is rightly selected. So like default language is C sharp. We can easily short it by just simply clicking on this, and see we have this couple of projects left now. And platform, you can choose Windows. So these are all Windows applications, so you can choose Windows. And I'm going to click on this console app and click on next. So here you need to give the project name. So let's give the project name as Hello C Sharp. So this is where our project is going to be located. Totally fine. Solution name will be Hello C Sharp, right? Just simply click on next. So our current .NET version is version 6.0, which is also selected over here, which is basically our long-term support. So if you want to increase your .NET version to .NET version 7, which is still not long-term support, so they have just released it. So that also you can choose it from this drop-down, right? Other things are fine. Just simply click on create, and it's going to start creating our project. So again, this creation of project will take a couple of minutes. So I'll be coming back after creation of our project. And you can see our project is rightly launched over here. So they have already created a new Hello World program. So console.writeline Hello World. And here if you see, this is our solution Hello C Sharp. And below that we have a project called Hello C Sharp, right? So on that project we have several dependencies. So if you click on this drop down and framework, you can see we have this Microsoft.NET code app rightly there. And then we have our C Sharp program. So that this is our main program, right? And a sample code is already written over here. So here if you just simply click on this run button, you can see it will start building our project. And once our building gets succeeded, you'll be able to see this pop-up. That is our command prompt, and here is the output Hello World rightly shown, Right. So in this, you can easily install the latest version of Visual Studio, that is Visual Studio 2022, on a Windows operating system. And then I have also shown you how you can easily create a simple C# console application and how to run that on our command prompt. So that's basically all about this video. If you face any difficulty during this installation, you can always comment. I am always there to help you. And if you like the video, please give it a like and also please do share it with friends. That will really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching and God bless you all.